On July 13th, 2013, three revolutionary black organizers created a black-centered movement building project called hashtag Black Lives Matter. This was in response to the acquittal of Trayvon Martin's murderer, George Zimmerman. The shooting of this innocent, unarmed black teenager was only the start. The Black Lives Matter movement was started because of the disproportionate percentage of violence, mistreatment, and even deaths of blacks. Black people accounted for 23% of killing victims in 2017, even though we only make up 13% of the US population. It wasn't started to make other races uncomfortable or angry. It was just the opposite. It was to say that black lives, which have historically and still even today, are not often as valued. We do matter and are equally as valuable. Being an African-American young woman in a predominantly white county may not be uncommon. Being one of the few, and most times the only, African-American student in an above advanced level class is not so uncommon. Being an African-American who talks white is not common. Being labeled as the whitest black girl you know is not a compliment. I will not apologize for my use of correct English at the correct time and place. Despite the comments heard and looks received, I embrace my individuality and continue to knock down racial and gender barriers. I'm not trying to nor want to be like anyone but myself. Yes, we all have different standards. Yes, we all have different morals. But we are all running to the same finish line. We are all striving to be the best we can be. I aim to bring attention to the victories and universal impact black people have on this earth. In the classroom, we as students are taught that slavery was once a thing, and now it's not. That black people couldn't eat in the same restaurant as white people, but now they can. Our history books are filled with pictures of slaves in shackles. The only school literature we read is about slaves or the social struggle of blacks. Sometimes being the only black student in the classroom is enraging, even disrespectful. Where is the real, complete history of blacks? What we're never taught is how African Americans rose from literally being owned as property to sitting in the Oval Office, to creating television networks, to wearing Olympic medals around their necks, to winning Grammy and Oscar awards. If the education curriculum was changed, black history can be American history. It should be. We 7 billion human beings walk upon the same grass, breathe the same air, attend the same schools, push through the same daily struggles. We need to pave our empathy, dialogue, and communication among each other to begin a peaceful, unified walk upon common ground. People need to realize that behind the color of our skin, we are all the same. Human beings with dreams and hopes and extraordinary minds to figure out solutions that will allow us to leave behind a safe and healthy world for our future, not the toxic, unwelcoming ground we presently inhabit. Change needs to start now. Change should have started 155 years ago when all slaves were freed. Individuals with social platforms need to use their power to fight the stereotypes, assumptions, and negativity to reveal the vision and intelligence behind our people. We all have voices that need to be heard. Thank you for allowing me to use my platform to bring forth the strength, beauty, and talent of our people. Be the change. Thank you.